To determine the sum of several integers, we'll work our way from left to right, determining one sum at a time. So for negative 6 plus positive 4 plus negative 7, we'll first determine the sum of negative 6 and positive 4. So if we think of this in terms of money, we can think of this as a loss of $6 plus a gain of $4. So the result would be a loss of $2, so this sum would be negative 2. Or if we're using the more formal rules to add these integers, we should notice that negative 6 will outweigh the positive 4, so the result will be negative. And then because the integers have different signs, we subtract their absolute values, which would be 2, but we know it has to be negative 2. So now we have negative 2 plus negative 7. So again, thinking of this in terms of money, negative 2 is like a loss of $2 plus a negative 7, which is like a loss of $7. Well, if we lose $2 and then lose $7, we have a total loss of $9. Or using the more formal rules of integers, because we're adding integers with the same sign, we add the absolute values and then keep the sign of the original integers, which would give us a sum of negative 9. For the second example, we'll start with positive 11 plus negative 2, which would give us positive 9. So we have positive 9 plus negative 5 plus 3. And now we'll determine the sum of positive 9 and negative 5. And again, noticing the positive 9 is going to outweigh the negative 5. So this will be positive 4, and then positive 4 plus 3 is 7. So our first sum was negative 9, and our second sum was positive 7.